Come here. Let me show you something. What is it? $3 to $4 million. A sports card. What? Legit. $3 to $4 million of sports cards. What am I talking about? And why is this important to you? In this episode with my mentor, Patrick Ben David, host of Valuetainment, we're gonna take a little peek into inside, a little some here, starting in 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor. Yeah, I'm getting bigger.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from Oak Brook Terrace, Illinois, fresh off the plane from Boca Raton. I'll tell you, man, I left 80 degree weather and I'm back to 30, 40 degrees, snowy and chilly. But nonetheless, I was honored to be a guest on the Ben David podcast, where we talked about all sorts of topics. We talked about Biden, we talked about California tax, we talked about, you know, the China type of situation, what's going on with our country. So please check out this episode here of the Ben David Show. The coolest part, I got to see the home, the brand new home in Boca Raton, the new home of Valuetainment. Also, grabbed a cigar in the backyard of Patrick's brand new home. We're smoking a cigar and closed out night. We're just calling our team from all across the country. The backyard was into coastals. It's just crazy, the type of neighborhood and neighbors they're around there. Now, on to the $3 to $4 million sports cards. I'm guessing you want to know what the heck I'm talking about. Now, about a month ago, I did an episode of how you can take your stimulus check and flip that stimulus check into millions of dollars and use that stimulus check as a seed to building up a $1 million portfolio, yes, of sports cards. And with inside that episode, I broke down the millionaire math of how to flip baseball cards, sports cards, basketball cards, and start building up this $1 million amount of money through, yes, sports cards and collectibles. And many of you are telling me, good luck with that. Good luck with that. Let's check out some of these comments. Good luck with that. Well, to show you the real opportunity of sports cards, of what it can turn into and compound it over a period of time, let's take a look here on the kitchen table of my mentor, Patrick Ben David, as he reveals something special here. Let's check this out.
I show up here to Patrick's house. He's exposed my world to sports cards investing, and I'm very happy and proud of my recent investments. I have a Jason Tatum card, PSA 10, and very happy with my Barry Bonds, PSA 10, and I'm very happy also with my refractor, Russell Wilson. But Patrick has to say, hey, Sapaula, here's what I got. Boom! What do we got? We got some Trae Youngs, got some, by the way, that's not one Trae Young, not the Lucas. Let me flip this around. And this is just a portion of Patrick's collection. Let's check this out. PBD. What do we have? Okay. What do we have here?
So you gotta have some Lucas. I got about 10 of these Lucas PSA 10s. Prism. Trae Young, he could be the next Steph Curry because he can play long term. I got 70 of his cards. I bought the first month of COVID. I got Bonds because I think Bonds will eventually go into the Hall of Fame. I got six over there. I got 19 here.
So you obviously like that card better than this.
Yeah, well, that's his second year. That's his first year. 1986 is Topps traded as his first year. Got it. That's second. Bo Jackson, rookie. Few Bernie's. Barry Sanders. I almost called Barry Sanders Bernie Sanders. I'm sorry, Barry. But three Bernie's, Barry Sanders. I got a one of one. Garoppolo. I got a bunch of Gretzky's. I'm sorry, Griffey's. Ted Williams.
Speaking of Gretzky.
Play ball.
If you saw the LA Times of somebody selling a Gretzky card for a little over $1 million, total $2.1 million, it's PBD.
Gretzky, and then over here.
He's got OPG and the Topps one.
OPG and Topps 10, Pop 2, you got it. Wow. So then here we got this one that's it's a pretty special card right
there.
Wow. Ruth 33, PSA 8, tough to find that. This one's a magical card. Wow. Zion, if you get close, here's 3 out of 5.
Wow.
National Treasure, there's only 5 of these. This is probably, I don't know, $450,000, $500,000 card right now. We got Giannis, we got Will Chamberlain, which is...
Can you talk about the Black Label significance?
Black Label, it's. I mean, you look at 9.5 BGS is a good grading, but a Black Label, you got centering is 10, edges is 10, corners is 10, surface is 10. It's a beautiful card. And it's Giannis. Giannis is eventually going to win. Wilt, this is a PSA 8. So funny. This card I bought I literally bought this card for $6,000-$7,000. That card today is a six-figure card. Yeah.
How long have you been collecting?
Since I was 12.
Wow.
Yeah, but you know, this is just some of the stuff that I have. I have more stuff upstairs. I have to get the boxes, but you know, once you gotta love this game. If you love it, you can have a lot of fun with it. And you know, there's a total everything together is around three. Not here. Total together is $3 to $4 million of collection.
Dream Beauty, thank you, Sharon.
I know that's insane, right? Right there on the kitchen table, equivalent to stacks of cash and gold bars. $3 to $4 million of sports cards on the kitchen table. Patrick collecting since the age of 12 years old. Did you see that one card? That card he purchased was a Wilt Chamberlain card about years ago for $6,000, and today he can sell it and it's worth over six figures. And as a personal example too, take my own medicine. Some of the stuff I'm giving you here in the Seven Figure Squad. I took a Kobe Bryant card. It was a Topps Chrome, I had a 1996 rookie card. I purchased it for $1,500. Sent it into a grader. I sent it to a guy here locally, to a sports store, and had a guy look at it, grade it, and see if it was worthy to send to either PSA or Beckett. He says send it to PSA. 3 weeks later, I get it back from PSA. I spent $250 to grade it. It turned into a PSA rated 9. So I took a $1,500 investment, $200 to $300 to grade it. Now I can sell it in the marketplace for $10,000. So it's just the same amount of money I took, equivalent to somebody's stimulus check, and now 3-4 weeks later, flip it into an $8,500 profit. See, this stuff isn't rocket science. You see, there are many ways for you to build your wealth nowadays. It's one of the easiest times for you to be a first generation cash flow millionaire. As long as you're willing to do the research, you're willing to do the homework, you're able to not spend stupid money, you're able to smartly apply whatever money you have as capital towards things that you know will systematically produce you a profit, the possibilities are endless these days. And with my own personal investment into my own cards, I did a IG live on it the other week. Just a small investment will allow me to step that up into the purchase of bigger cards, which means bigger opportunities. And one by one, yours truly, and many of you watching this channel, are building up a new asset class of money in sports cards. And before I let you go, here's that video once again. How to take and flip your $600 stimulus check and make millions off it if you're smart. And here's another video you should check out. If I took a small bit of capital, $500, in the last 5-6 years turned it into a $42 million company with just that small amount of cash. And again, I'm not a rocket scientist. I don't have a college degree. I was a United States Marine, for crying out loud. I have zero sales background, has zero business or financial background. If a guy like me can figure out, there's plenty of hope for many of you. So with that being said, guys, let me know your thoughts, your follow-ups, your comments, your questions. Drop it in the comments section. But what do you think about Patrick's collection of sports cards that he's collected and upgraded over a period of time? See, it's not instant wealth. It's a progression. It takes studying. You know, you're proactive, you're pragmatic about your investments, your decisions. Drop your comments in the comment section below. If you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Mighty Smart Guy. And if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe and hit notifications to be alerted next time we upload our next episode. Seven Figure Squad, a YouTube channel to help you think like a millionaire, strategize like a millionaire, so therefore you can become a first generation cash flow millionaire. That being said, guys, I'm your Mighty Smart Guy. And until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.